Hello everybody from Plant Reviews UK. Today is the 5th of September and I'm talking today about a beautiful bulbous plant that I have in a pot in my allotment, but can be also grown outdoors in some areas of the United Kingdom and in USDA Zone 8, and this is Eucomis comosa Sparkling Burgundy. Eucomis is a genus of flowering plant in the family Asparagaceae, so in the Asparagus family, and the subfamily Scilloidaeae. To this group, the subfamily Scilloidaeae, belong plants that are related to Eucomis, and these plants are hyacinths, bluebells, and muscari. The muscari also known as grape hyacinths. And indeed, all these plants come from bulbs. Unlike the grape hyacinth or the hyacinths, and the bluebells that usually grow between winter and spring and bloom in spring, Eucomis instead is dormant in winter. The leaves start appearing in spring and it blooms in summer. Eucomis are perennial plants. I've been keeping this particular plant already from 4 years, and they are commonly known as pineapple lilies or pineapple flowers. The reason is that from a rosette of leaves in the center comes up a flower stem that is covered usually from for a third of its length by a multitude of flowers that are topped at the end of the flower stem by some leaves. Now, in most of Eucomis, the leaves are not true leaves, they are bracts. And in most Eucomis species, they are green. However, in this variety, Sparkling Burgundy, due to the fact that it has been selected with a purplish color, the whole, as you can see, purplish reddish color, the whole plant, including the bracts at the end, are burgundy. However, if you see other species of Eucomis, for example the normal green Eucomis comosa, or for example the Eucomis autumnalis white dwarf, I made a video about this Eucomis last year. I will put a link in the description. You can clearly see the tuft of green bracts at the top of the flower spike, and really the resemblance to a pineapple is quite striking. The plant is member, as I said, of the genus Eucomis, and in Eucomis there are about a dozen species. They are all native to southern Africa. Even if they are African species, some of these species are actually hardy in the United Kingdom as well as in other temperate climates in USDA, down to USDA zone 8, and they can handle down to minus 10 degrees. The most important is that being Eucomis dormant in winter, and in the United Kingdom and other temperate countries, sometimes in winter the temperature are close to freezing, with some days with a few degrees below 0 degrees Celsius. Bulb needs to be as dry as possible, so it is very important that the plant is in very well drained soil and in full sun, in order that even in winter the rain or the snow that might fall on the ground, it is easily drained in the soil. And also, if these plants are put in pot, is always better to place them in a protected area, ideally frost free, because in a pot obviously the swings in temperature are a lot more extreme than in the open ground. This said, however, I have to say that in my in Kent, where I live, that is USDA Zone 8, I forgot this pot outside this year, and even if we had the snow and the temperatures about minus 7 degrees Celsius for a week, the plant survived perfectly, and indeed you can see not only grew a beautiful rosette of leaves that unfortunately is not so beautiful anymore because they have been eaten by slugs, but also bloomed beautifully this year. The Eucomis in most Eucomis species in Africa grow in areas that, even if they are well drained, they have moisture when there are quite a lot of moisture during the active period of growth. And this is something that is also very important to provide in Eucomis, comosa, sparkling Burgundy. They don't like to dry up too much when they are in active growth, so between summer and spring, between spring and summer, so ensure that you water the plant regularly. The plant is a plant that is actually pretty easy to find in garden centers as well as online shops. The bulbs need to be planted in spring. Indeed, they are usually available in the spring bulb season, so usually between March and April up to June, and after planting they need to be planted about 10-15 centimeters deep, and in spring they grow these leaves that are kind of reddish, I would say. Yeah, reddish burgundy, as the name says. You can see the burgundy is even more evident at the base of the leaves, while the leaves develop, the burgundy kind of fades in a brownish green. It's still a very beautiful color. You can see the contrast against the green grass, and in a garden is definitely worth cultivating it because of the nice contrast it provides against most of the plants that have usually green foliage anyway. The leaves are up to 60 centimeters long, and they are in a rosette that can actually open quite wide, so if you have plants nearby, be sure that they are quite robust, so they are not damaged or kind of deformed in their growth by the quite heavy leaves that open up in an area of about 60 centimeters from the center of the plant. The Eucomis comosa is a plant from South Africa, and is as I said the normal, the usual species is green, but this one is a reddish variety, and I think the Eucomis comosa as a species, the green one, is also very pretty, and the similarity to a pineapple of the flower stem is even closer, because the flowers are more like greenish white. So the resemblance to a pineapple is a lot closer than in the Eucomis sparkling Burgundy, and also the some areas of the flower are quite brown as well in the Eucomis species, so it is really striking the similarity to a pineapple. Anyway, for the color, I think this one provides a better contrast with the other garden plants. As I said, after putting the bulbs, they need to be planted anyway in well-drained soil and full sun. Keep the soil moist, and the plants will develop first the leaves and then a flower stem that can grow up to 60 centimeters tall. And on the flower stem, that is a rich burgundy, as you can see, a multitude of flowers start developing. The flowers are about 2 centimeters in diameter, and they are Burgundy, oh, there is a bumblebee that decided to pollinate these flowers. Well, these flowers are actually quite good for pollinators. They really love it. And these flowers, I was saying, they're about 2 centimeters across and pink. They're not very fragrant. They are kind of very, very lightly fragrant, kind of a honey scent in this Eucomis Sparkling Burgundy, but is very, very light. If you want an Eucomis that has a lot, that is a lot more fragrant, the scent is really, really medium intense. It's not a scent that permeates the garden, but it's definitely a scent that you can detect it very easily when you're close to the flowers. Is the dwarf Eucomis, the Eucomis dwarf white, Eucomis autumnalis dwarf white. I will put the link in the description, as well as the link at the end of the video. And this variety is a really, really rich coconut scent. Really. Really nice to smell. This Eucomis Burgundy, I would recommend it not much for the scent, for the fragrance, but rather for the beautiful color, as well for the beautiful flower stem, so covered in flowers, and also because it's loved by pollinators. You can see that the flowers are star-shaped, and they are a kind of liked pink on the tepals, with a very rich pinkish purple where the stigma is, surrounded by anthers that have purple filaments and a bright yellow pollen. So the details of the flowers are very elegant. I think that it is a beautiful plant to have in the garden. It's is really, really striking, this plant. The flowers open up in across several weeks. This plant started to bloom a few days before I went in holidays to Italy, so about 3 weeks ago. So you can see that the flowers that open first are still open from 3 weeks, and even if actually the flowers have already faded, the nice feature of Eucomis is that even if the flowers have already faded, the petals stay in place, and the seed pod where the developing seed capsule is originating stays on the flower stem. So actually the faded flower, you can see they are faded because they are really dark burgundy. They are not this pale pink as the fresh flowers. The flowers, they are still in bloom. They basically look like just normal flowers. And it is therefore a flower display that can last several weeks. This plant started blooming around the 10th of August, and today is the 5th of September, and the plant is still in full bloom. And actually I have still some buds that are still opening, so it's really a very long, you can see the buds here, this dark burgundy buds. So if you want a plant with a very long flower display, definitely Eucomis comosa Sparkling Burgundy is one that you will love. About the price, it's a pretty expensive plant. I found most the average price being between £4 and £6 per bulb, so it is a very, very affordable plant for everyone. And a bonus is that in many parts of the United Kingdom and in USDA Zone 8 is a plant that you can grow outdoors all year round. After the blooming in autumn, the plant leaves die down, and obviously the flower stem dies down as well. If you want, you can obviously collect the seed from the seed capsules to propagate the plant, but the propagation from seed takes a few years until blooming. Otherwise, anyway, this plant produces bulblet, and you can see this other plant that didn't bloom yet. It's an offset from this plant, that is the mother plant. I would say that all in obviously in winter dies down, so it doesn't need any fertilizing in winter, while it's definitely recommendable regular fertilizing in spring and summer when the plant is in active growth. So I want to finish this video showing you at a distance the plant, so you can have a pretty good idea of the overall appearance of the plant. And you can see it is a really, really beautiful plant. If you plant it in groups in the mid borders, it's really, really impressive, and bees and bumblebees will definitely love this plant. As usual, I hope that you enjoy the video. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up, and if you like this video and the other videos on my channel, would be great if you can please subscribe. Subscribing to my channel is completely free for you, but in this way YouTube gets notified that you like my videos, and therefore can promote my channel on the platform. And as usual, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.